Charmander. He's got a basic Pac-Man mouth coming out. Then he's got a body that looks like a kind of Yoshi dinosaur body. Or like a little Mr. Potato Head body. And a little Pac-Man nose. But he's got a little snout coming out. And his head cuts right about there. And he's got a little bit of chinny chin shape. And right about here, the circle belly starts cutting. He's got some little tiny looking feet with some claws, but for now I'm just gonna leave him open. And he's got a tail coming out. And it kind of tapers to a small Charmander. Is a kind of lizard Pokemon from a cartoon universe, and he has a fire powers, so he has a little tongue sticking out with some little fangy fangs. Yeah, it basically looks like a dinosaur. I don't really like that, but I'll work with it for now. So, now he has some flames shooting out. Got some really organic looking lines that go into some pointy shapes, and I got a little bit of whip flames coming out. And he's got a little bit of flame coming out of his tail too. Alright. He's got some little spiky things coming out of his toes. A little bit of arm flapping up here behind his head. Got a little tiny hand action going on. Alright, so now go ahead and smudge this a little bit to lighten it up. Now, let's go ahead and mix in some colors. A little bit of water. And go ahead and, I got two little drops, I'm gonna point them in. I'm gonna mix it till I got a nice Charmander kind of pale color. Here we go. Go ahead and color this in. Trying my best to make the lines nice and flowy. lighter color orange, which is a kind of secondary color that I'm going to use to make him kind of have a shadow effect. So right along in his body that's kind of closer to you, go ahead and throw this mix of yellow ochre with a little bit of orange in it, just a little bit, to make it kind of orange looking but not really orange. And all that's lightened up here is his cheek and his jaw. A nice light cheek area. Make a nice shadow on his arm to his chest a little bit. A little bit of shade on his hip. That's just mostly a perfect circle, it looks like. A little bit of water. Teardrop shape for highlight. That's all we're doing, is basically highlighting the parts of his body where that are catching light, and the parts that are more orange are the parts that are slightly out of the light. And I'm gonna go ahead and throw some straight up ochre right about here and here. A little bit in the back of his head. There we go. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take a little bit of white and just dab it a little bit on my little makeshift cardboard palette. I'm gonna take some of this white, drag it out, and drag some of this ochre color that I mixed in. And I'm gonna go ahead and make the underbelly. But I need some more whites. So I got a nice white color for his belly. It does have a little bit of shadow on it. But since my painting is not really cooperating, I'm gonna take straight white and just kind of fade it in. Blending right on your thingy, right on your sticker, sorry. Go ahead and put these highlights in. A little bit of highlight there. There's a little white around there under the foot. Then he has these little claws. Those into kind of thick lines. Now I want to twist this brush real tight. Oh, let's clean it off here. Twist it real tight to make a nice point. Or kind of a whippy tail. And I twist it, dip, twist it, roll it out, and then I got kind of the teeth white, even though they're already white. Make a little bit more. I'm gonna go ahead and make his tongue this kind of peach color that's already on my clean my brush up. And I have some straight orange. Take some straight orange and put it right in the middle. And kind of blush it out a little bit. So I make a kind of round blushy triangle right there. That looks pretty good so far. Now, whoops. I'm going to take some of this straight yellow. Just a real little tiny bit. I just got a real tiny little fingernail drop. I'm going to go ahead and move my painting to kind of get it in the light better. I'm going to go in these flames. Take some of the orange that I already got, straight solid orange. And what I'm gonna do is start highlighting areas of fire. Take our black. I still have black poured from the last thing. A little bit of water. Make it kind of inky. You can run a test. It needs a little bit more water. Test. Alright, I got a nice liney line. Go ahead and cut a nice high looking slit. And a little wrinkle right there. There we go. And so now what we'll start doing is start cutting an outline. I'm going to start in the armpit, go around to the backside area, stop, dip, start from the back of the heel, connect those in real nice. You're gonna see. Just go around the shapes you already got. Don't gotta be perfect. We'll be right back. So right where I have these nice outlines, I'm gonna go in there gray with the dark. Whoops, I almost colored in his teeth. Gonna mix some ink. Make these little pointy shapes up here.